And that's what we need. Our return on investment is coming in. Between the staff house and this chicken house, we are supposed to have a line of defense. All right, welcome. This is a 5,000 capacity layer pen that we are constructing. And I just want to take you around it. In case you're asking, how much land do I need to have something like this? So I'll just start with this as a case study. This is a typical example now. So we have a 5-acre plot of land here. But, you know, if you look at the structures that we have here, there's ample space from the entrance to this staff area. And, you know, there's supposed to be an admin area here, but we're going to make use of this for now. So we have three rooms for the staff. We have an office space. Then we have two stores. We're going to be using that for the feed and for the eggs. Of course, we are here for the eggs. So we're going to be using one of the stores for the eggs, one of the stores for the feed. We also have a kitchen. We have the general toilet. Each of the rooms is en suite, so it has its own toilet and bath. It's yet to be finished, though. As we proceed, we'll show you more. All right, so 5 acres, and we have just used a tiny portion of the land, just one side. This is the left side of the farm, and we still have land all over here. So according to our plan, we can have another 5,000 capacity here, and then 10,000. Altogether, we should be able to have 30,000 capacity. But you know, let's get into the chicken house and see what we have. So there's something that is important and we must mention. You know, a lot of people, they mess up in this area, and that's biosecurity. Between the staff house and this chicken house, we are supposed to have a line of defense. So what I mean is we are going to have an entrance here. It's going to be just a narrow entrance. So not everybody just comes from any angle into this area. So anybody who is passing here has to be approved. It has to be a worker. So in case, you know, people might have access to this area because there's going to be a store there and probably a relative of the worker, anybody comes to the farm and they have access to this staff area, but they shouldn't have access to this place. So it's going to be, there's going to be a barrier here. And that's very important, biosecurity. Because the house is also still under construction, we are yet to fix the foot dip, and that's where we are going to be putting the disinfectants. So before you enter the pen, you dip your leg inside this. We are going to make a step here so it's not too high, because right now it's pretty high. So we have the foot dip, maybe a step before the foot dip, and all that is also biosecurity. And I think this is what a lot of people talk about, but there's more. There's more to biosecurity than that. All right, so you can see.
Now, if you're here to subscribe to my channel, honestly, I don't know what you're waiting for. Click on that subscribe button so YouTube shows you more of my educative videos that will teach you more on poultry farming. Let's continue.
It's still littered because they're still installing the cages. I think they are almost done installing the cages. We are yet to connect the pipes to the tank. These are the buckets for the water to be serving each of the tiers of the cages. And you can see the cage is really well aligned and just really good. One other thing that I always advise is that once you are going this capacity, this is a 5,000 capacity pen, it's always advisable that you go automatic when it comes to manure removal. So you don't want your workers to push manure with their hands from this end to the other hand. It's a lot of work, and you know, staffing can be difficult when you have so much to do. But if you can just press a button and you know, you remove your manure, I think the rest of the work is just to serve the feed, checking of the health of the birds, you monitor the water and all that. So we have 42 units of the cages here, and we're looking at adding 2 extra units on this line. We have 22 here and 20 here, so there's a little space at the back that can take 2 extra units. So all together we'll be having over 5,000 birds when this space is stocked. All right, so again, one other thing I want to talk about is the biosecurity inside the pen. Up here we have the roof part, it's netted. That means we can't have birds coming in here because birds can transfer diseases. So it's netted over there, and at the hedge too, it's also netted. We're trying as much as possible to prevent birds from entering, as well as rodents. So this floor you're seeing is concrete, solid concrete. So we don't expect any normal rats, any normal rodent to dig in. It's solid enough to prevent them from breaking in and all that. So the walls are also sealed from the hedge of the roof to the skirt of the house there. Everything is sealed. So we don't want rodents coming in. And this space also, because this is where the manure will be going out, we are here to finish this part. So we're going to break this part, we're going to open it, and then channel the waste that is coming from that part of the house into the pit. There's a big pit over here, about 20 by 10 by 10. Yeah, so whatever is coming in here is going out. And that means we have an opening over here that rodents can come in. After each manure removal operation, we are going to be locking this part. So there's going to be a kind of, we're going to build something, we'll fabricate a material to close this so that rodents don't come in. So why are we stopping rodents? Are they not harmless? Why are we stopping birds from entering into the pen? Because these things transfer diseases. Rodents transfer about 45 diseases or so, and birds too can transfer diseases, very crazy diseases that can kill our birds, our chickens, and can affect their production negatively. We don't want that to happen. So all these are important. You can see over here too, we are supposed to have a foot deep, and then come see something. You can see the edge of the house here. You can see erosion can wash this thing, can begin to eat into this area. So we are going to have a walkway all around the pen, about 3 feet away from the wall. So we're going to have a walkway like this all around. So they are fabricating blocks. We're going to lay the blocks on the floor and then fill it and then cement it. So we have a walkway, and that also helps us to prevent, you know, it's a kind of security so that if the watchman at night is just moving around and, you know, from one end of the house, he puts on his torch, he can see if anything is trying to enter into the pen. Maybe there's soldier ants or snakes and all those things. You discourage them when you keep grasses and weed away from the chicken house. So we're just trying to do everything possible to make sure that this house is ready as soon as possible to receive point of lay or point of cage pullets. And that's what we need. Once we get that in, then we need solid management so that we can start rolling out eggs, and then our return on investment is coming in. One more thing that is important to say is the tank that we have inside here. You see, it has to be protected from direct sunlight. There is a plan to have the other water tank with that tank over there on top of it and another one. So one is going to serve the staff quarters and this one would serve the chicken house. So we will have one outside, which is a external reservoir, and we'll have another one inside here. And then this is where we'll be dosing their medications. So the water is going to be going directly from here into the cages, into the nipple line, and that is how we do it. So another thing that is good to say is the materials, the equipment that you use. A lot of people will say that poultry, you know, investing in poultry now is difficult. Things are really expensive. But if you look at it in the long run, it's better to invest in solid equipment. What you have here is the hot dip galvanized cages that will give you 20 years plus durability. So these things will remain like this for 20 years as long as you maintain it well enough. You can see the trough, the feeding trough is well built, spacious. It won't cut you even at points where it joins together. You know, it's just all plastic, all solid plastic. and it can easily spread the feed. You know, your worker is not thinking about going to do that operation that will cut his hand. He's just going to do another safe operation. So it encourages them to do what they need to do. So solid cage, solid structure, everything solid, you know, the scraper in place. There's no how you won't have workers that are interested in working, you know. Yeah, of course, they are here to earn themselves the money for a living. But if you make the operation easy enough, you know, maybe they can even find passion in the business that you're doing. All right, so I'll leave you with one more tip. And this is the reason why a lot of farms fail. They think they have done everything right, but then they are doing a lot of things wrong. Okay.
One thing that you should never do is to transfer objects, tools, and equipment from one pen to another, or from the pen to the staff area. For biosecurity reasons, everything that is meant for a particular pen has to remain in that pen. Otherwise, you could be transferring diseases from an already infected flock to an uninfected flock. Okay, so whatever is designated for a particular pen has to remain in that pen.